Hello everyone and welcome to part 3 of the roofing tutorial. In this part we are going over some questions that came out of the community. And the first question was, how about a porch? How do you roof a porch? Well, I'm gonna show you. First we're going to start off with just a simple small porch at the front of the home. So you can do that multiple ways. You can use the half-hipped roof. You place it like this. You drag it so it fits the whole area and just slide it down. That's just one of the ways you can do it. And also you can use the shed roof if you like. Like that. Just drag it and let it go down. And there you have it. And the roof won't go through the room because it's one room. So that's fairly easy, so you can just drag it through, even if you would drag it all the way across like that, it wouldn't show. It's not maybe very pretty, but it doesn't show. So that is good to know. If you want to have a porch that goes all around the house, that's also very doable. So let's make that. For that I'm mostly using the hipped roof and we're just dragging it across the home and sliding it down, and there you have a totally covered porch with roof. And also you can, of course, if you want to make roof a porch here, you can just slide it, make the porch and everything is covered. So that are the ways to make a porch home. And of course you can finish it off just by clicking a hip roof there and maybe an A-frame here. So you have a little cute home. You can place some windows and, well, you know the drill. So that's how you do it. So let's go to a next house. So with this next home, you will see it's a diagonal roof. I got multiple questions about that. So let's go over that one. It's not very easy. It's also not a very basic, normal roof type to have. At least I live in the Netherlands, in Europe, and we don't have much diagonal walls or roofs here. So it's not a very common roof to use. You can do it in multiple ways. Just slide them a bit through and to the back. And then you can fill up the holes there. Also drag them a bit so you don't get the weird shapes. And as you can see, they disappear when entering the room, because the room is more important than the roof. I don't know, but in the basics it works just like that. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. And then you can finish it off however you want, but you can also use, oh, that's the wrong one. You see, I'm not very much using these kind of roofs. You can also use an A-frame roof and just slide it a little bit down and just drag it so it's all covered, the spots here and here. And then have this roof and just drag that. And now you're gonna say to me, but the roof is showing through the A-frame and it's ugly. Well, we're going to do something about that. I will show you. First, I'm gonna drag this a little bit more down, like this. And now you see, indeed, it goes through the points, which I don't... It's possible, but it's not very pretty. But if you make it smaller, that is also an option, so it doesn't go through. But I figured we can use that and just... Don't use the wrong one. Oh, no. Where are you? This one. It's like this. also a little bit down and finish it off with some lovely trims. And you can have a little bit of a roof here, but maybe that is for the build you're looking for, maybe a great option. Otherwise, it's just slightly increase the roof so it fits like this, and then build the other roofs around it. And of course, trim it off just like that. And then you finish off the roof here, just slide it here, and then you have some covered. Maybe you can make a porch here, go with an A-frame to finish this side. Also drag it a little bit down because we drag this roof down, and otherwise it won't fit perfectly. It has to go slightly down some more, so like this. And then you can finish the rest of the builds because these are all square, so that's mostly very easy to do. You can go with this one, an A-frame for here. Just make sure every point connects. You can go here through here, and hip proof for this, like that, and maybe a large A-frame for here, and then you have finished your home. And you can also make little windows here, or around here, or here, just whatever you like. Just play with the options you have a little bit too, and also look at the style of the build you're building. Because of this wood, it's mainly slightly older, but the diagonal wall is not really something that goes into old buildings. Only those are mainly more square-like. So maybe this is, you can make this into a modern home and have a flat roof. So it just goes, you can make it like this. And then finish it off and maybe put a fence, a little fence there. And you can also just make it into a square, so a little part of the porch is covered. It's all personal taste, so whatever you like. A little bit down there, like that. So you see the diagonals all go underneath this room, and it's all covered up. So it's what you want to portray with your build, the style you're building. And I would suggest look on Google, Pinterest, or something else to see what kind of roofing those kind of builds have. So if you're looking for something Victorian or really old or Gothic style, it's mostly a mansard roof. So you can look with those different kind of things and make your roof like that, or just have a fantasy home and make it whatever you want. There are no specific rules for that, but sometimes it can help to look at real life buildings so you can see what type of roofing they used. So you can use that in The Sims as well. So next we have a question of Laura Jertman, and this is the house she made, and she wants to know how she can improve the roofing on this because she isn't really happy with it. So of course I'm gonna help her out, and this is how it looks now, just going around and around and around and around and around, so you can see how it looks. I'm gonna remove all the roofs, and we're going to make this into a slab. Multiple roofs like that. This is also a roof. I'm just making it all disappear. As you can see, it's a pool house, slightly modern. So I'm going to use somewhat modern roofing for this, and it's a very big square. So we're gonna optimize that with the shed roof. Just drag it across, and we're going to make it like this, because here I want to finish this all off. So you can use it like that. Second room here. We're gonna use multiple roofs. it's just one letter difference, but the big difference. And I'm going to paint the roofs. We're just going to real finish it off like a proper house. And you will see here we have a little corner sticking out of the house. So I'm gonna somewhat butterfly this roof going down like that. And so it doesn't stick out. I don't like it. Go like that. And finish it off as well with the trim here. So this is the basic with which we're going to work. Here's a slight part as well. Going to make it into like this. So you see you have multiple rooms and you can make it however you want, maybe like this. So it has more volume. Maybe slightly, a little bit more down. Yeah, just like that. And because she has no windows here, but it's a very big space like that, I'm gonna use this roof there. And maybe trim. Oh, no, trim. Where is the trim thing? Oh, there you are. Like that, and just copy the roof like this and into there, and you can trim it back like that. Copy this roof, make it sure all the trims go good again, so like this. And what I like to do is, because now you can think it's still somewhat boring, I suggest not using the same pattern all over the house. Mix it up a little bit, because that makes the home feel more alive, more diverse, and it's prettier to look at. So we're going to use this one of Solani, but there's also... No, well, let's use the base game, because some people don't have everything. So let's use the base game. Going to make this. We have to fix this trim here as well, because that's not pretty. And just, I'm sorry I'm messing your build up if you don't like it, but I just want to show all the versatility you can have with just making the walls look different. And you have some pillars here, so going to use that as well. And it doesn't change anything on the inside. But the outside, it still looks somewhat more attractive. And, well, we can trim this side and the other side. So, like that. And trim this one as well, so it goes fluently over in each other. And, of course, a nice trim. Since it's a modern build, I really like to use this one. You will see that in multiple of my builds. I'm not very original like that, I just like it. And you can maybe also build in a skylight wherever you want. That's all up to you. You know how to do it if you watched part 2. And we have a little corner thing here. Now, the difficulty with this is, you build it next to a straight line. It doesn't go like this here, smooth into the wall. It's just a corner. So, if you're going to use a diagonal roof, and I have to like this, and also it just disappears into, but you see, it will disappear here. So I'm very sorry for your build, I'm gonna slightly make a little square like here. Alter the roof, and you can see now it fits really well within the build and on top of the little corner thingy window. There must be a proper word for it, but I have no idea and I'm too tired to look it up for now. So that's how you can fix that. And it's the same with the window. the window, the door. It's just placed beside, right at the corner of the home. If you look at most houses, doors are often more placed like not as close to the corner of the home. So watch where you put all kinds of that, because it also affects the roof you're going to build. Corners like that, corners like this. It also affects how you're able to roof your home well. Maybe we're just going to show like that. And you're just going around. And you can finish it off very easily, and it looks very different now than what we had. Oh, wait, a point is sticking out. Just drag it down. That's not a problem. See? So, like this. And then we have a totally different build. Or it looks different, but it is still the same. So that's how you do that. And I hope this was useful as well. If you still have questions, please let me know. I can make always another tutorial. And I love doing it. So if I'm able to help you out, I will. And thank you so much for watching part 3. Thank you all for your support. Remember, you're awesome. And I will see you in the next video.